Timberwolves. Covington at the four with Towns in at the five. Culver out there with Wiggins, and it's Graham in at the three spot. And for the Suns, inside Sharks and Baines. Rubio and Booker, they're the backcourt, and it's Oubre in at the small four. Great for the Phoenix Suns, the franchise high, 9-year playoff drought. There is pressure on this team to find their way out of that long rebuild.
And their moves on draft night, they raise some eyebrows. They've got some young talent, but can new coach Monty Williams turn them into a winner? Long-suffering Suns fans certainly hope so.
Now, here's Culver. Higgins outside. Pocket six. No good on the three. And it's Rubio with the ball to the Suns. Oubre passes to Rubio. Got a hand on it. And now Minnesota on the fast break. And Wiggins with the basket on the assist by Culver. Wiggins has got the first points up on the board for the Timberwolves. Rubio taking his time here. Pass to Booker. Here's Baines, covered by Wiggins. And Rubio kicks to Booker. Banked in off the glass.
Wiggins got to the 10. I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Well, this early, this should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
Here's Graham. Currently averaging almost 6 points a game. Pulls up from the corner. That one off the back iron and out.
Usually, guys, he's going to knock that one down from there. Proficient at operating in that medium range area.
Here's Baines. He's certainly been a consistent piece of their offense, averaging about 14 and a half points a game. A nice shot by Booker.
Well, he is looking confident. Love how they're using him so far.
And you know what? They're going to keep using him. I mean, he'll be the centerpiece of their offense today. You can bank on that.
How about the recognition from Culver? Terrific at realizing when the defense has broken down.
Rubio with pass to Booker. Here's Baines. Rubio right side. Booker with no one around. 3-pointers off the mark.
And you don't want to give up that kind of look too often.
Towns trying to get open, and it's Wiggins missing.
You know, sometimes making it difficult for him to finish at the rim is all you can ask for from the defense. You know, it's not been easy for Andrew Wiggins the last few seasons, guys. The production has just fallen short of expectations. He was the number one pick back in his draft class, and really has struggled to live up to what the fans have expected him to be.
It's a floater. Towns, no luck. And here's Sharks. He'll play it out for the Phoenix Suns. The dish to Oubre. The pass to Baines. Score the basket. His second of two attempts. Wiggins is clearly a talented player. The people just want more from him.
Yeah, I agree with you, Kevin. And a lot of it is a matter of consistency. And when the expectations are high, being a former overall number one pick, that pressure can affect you. But I think if Wiggins can just lock into being consistent, all of that will subside.
And first time out of the game called for Phoenix.
Every time out, a chance to review the lineups and matchups. Call a play.
And I agree. I think there's going to be a new wrinkle in their game plan when they come out of this timeout.
Mm-hmm. Jones in for Sharks. Mikal Bridges checked in for Newberry. Lance Johnson in for Ricky Rubio. Here's Diallo. He's usually able to provide some lift to his team, averaging 6 points a game. Kaminsky finds Booker. Pope loose. A shot off that time. Wiggins with some nice deep. Akoki, the pass to Bonley. Bridges against T. Pass to Chang. One up, one down. 2 points with his first shot this game. Who do you think is the best center right now, spacing the floor and also embracing the traditional responsibilities of the center?
Well, I tell you, it wasn't until the playoffs of this past season that I got to see Jokic. My goodness, he is a joy to watch. His footwork, his shot making, his skill, and I think his passing is probably the best attribute of his game.
Mm-hmm.
And I would put him in that category because he can make the big three and be the streaky from there. In terms of the balanced approach, I think probably I think I'll call Anthony Towns in that.
Good name. And the Timberwolves with possession here. After the Suns pick up two. There's 47 seconds left in the first quarter. Johnson with the puck. And Phoenix pushing it up now. Booker against Wiggins. And Booker gets to Johnson. This is it to Diallo. Timberwolves have gotten 5 of 10 shots from front in this game so far, right at the 50% mark. Outside T, fires from deep. No good that time. So at the end of one quarter of play, still a close game. Minnesota on top, up one. 2 game sports, back to Phoenix after this. Of this team.
Every day we're thinking about how can we be a team that we need to be to not only make the playoffs, but to make it deep into the playoffs and give ourselves a chance of being a championship team. We have so much talent, great veterans, we have a great front office, a great coaching staff, so with all that on our side, we feel we have a great chance to find our way to success.
One step at a time, Greg. That's the mindset to him.
Yeah, you can't have too much too early. But with Towns leading the charge, this team is in great hands.
And we hope you're enjoying the game. Both teams tonight keeping things pretty even so far in the scoreboard. Hey guys, what's your take so far in the Timberwolves?
Yeah, in that first period, they look to push in transition at every opportunity.
Yeah, I like the way they play. They're looking to get up and down the court every time. Racehorse basketball here tonight. Strap it up. Don't look down. You'll miss something.
Green Johnson fill out the wing. Bridges out there with Frank Kaminsky. And it's Johnson in at the one. So that's the Suns 5 as we get into the second quarter. Phoenix shooting their first free throws here tonight. First free throw is good.
Well, a promising start last year for Mikal Bridges. The offense was there, but it was his impact defensively that has really gotten most people's attention. A lot of great tools for a young player.
He hits both from the stripe. And with Bridges and his defense, great coaches speak very highly of his basketball IQ.
And that is why, as a rookie, he would often get assigned to guard the toughest perimeter player. Good size and great instincts make him one of the best young defenders on the team.
Sure, I mean, we'll see if they can maintain that aggressive approach, guys.
Here's G. Suns take it too. Used a shot fake to create the angle, but couldn't get it to fall. Johnson, the pass to commit. Johnson outside. That's his second shot on his second basket. He's 2 for 2. Timberwolves trail by 3.
They need a bucket in a big way here.
Shot from close range. Towns has got 5 points now this quarter.
And now
pitch to Johnson. Back to Rubio. To the paint. They get it. And a slam dunk by Diallo.
As you know, timing can be the difference between an assist and a turnover. That time, Rubio precise hitting the roll.
Now, here's Culver. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against the Lakers in Los Angeles. Shoots over Rubio, and the last second attempt is not going for him.
See, that's the defense you get with Rubio. 6'4", a really high basketball IQ. He finds a way to bother shots.
It's all tied in Phoenix. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Ricky, bench has always been an issue here. When they produce like they did in the first half, how does that help you?
It's amazing. That means like we have a deep bench, and then a lot of work from the staff, from the everybody of the team, like doing extra work and winning games.
Trying to change the culture around here. Thanks, Ricky. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David, for that interview, and we'll see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
It is a good game we have here after one half of play. Everybody, welcome back for our halftime show. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, and Kenny Strick. For the Suns, the first quarter was pretty even. They did jump out to a lead in the opening period, but 4 points was the biggest it got. The second quarter was a tight battle, but they were the slightly better team. Not by very much, however. Kenny, let's start with you. What did you think about the Suns?
Well, they're putting bodies on people. If you just look at the rebound, you can tell that they've been putting their body on and being more physical than the other team. And that fact looms large on both sides, and that's going to be the difference in the second half.
How about you, Shaq? What did you think about Minnesota?
Well, a lot of their points came in transition. They dictated the pace of the game. It was a fast pace. Defense back on the field. I say keep attacking the second half. Do not slow down.
And that should do it. With the second half about to begin, let's send you back to Kevin Harlan. Go back to Kevin Harlan. Go. Go over there.
The second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams try to gain an edge. You look at Johns, he's really been playing well.
He's done a fantastic job of finding open space to operate within the first few quarters.
You know what? It helped that they had a few guys with very hot hands on the perimeter, too.
And if you're just joining us, we played through the first half in a game that's been fairly even so far.
And the young Timberwolves head coach, Ryan Saunders, son of former Minnesota coach Cliff Saunders, about as great of a pedigree you could ask for as a young coach.
Well, guys, you've heard me talk about the DNA when it relates to players. It's the same with coaches. I mean, Ryan has grown up seeing his dad make the late Cliff Saunders, one of our favorites in the business. He spent his whole life around basketball, so he has a great way with players and a real good understanding of the game to a modern-day approach for a young coach.
Third quarter action getting rolling right now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's who's on the floor. And so in the game for the Timberwolves, Covington at the four with Towns in at the five. Andrew Wiggins is out there with Culver, and it's Graham in at the three. He's off on the first.
And it was made clear early on to Ricky Rubio that the Jazz were moving on from him. But Rubio quickly finds a home in Phoenix. 3-year deal for Rubio, who is a good fit with the Suns. Having a real point guard on the team like Rubio should be a huge boost.
And the second free throw, good. That defense clock being played now by a lot of teams. It's amazing that even with that, the point totals just continue to run.
And you know what, I attribute the point totals continuing to rise to a couple of things. One, the volume of three-point shots that are being taken, and I think teams are playing at a little faster pace universally. You don't see as much walking the ball up the floor as I think you may have seen in years past.
And then Culver with a quick dunk.
Unselfishness always admirable in a basketball player, and Covington consistent at giving it up when one of his teammates is open.
Pass to Baines. To the left wing. Covington dishes to Culver. The pass to Towns. Fires from 14. The shot's good. And it's a three-point Minnesota lead.
The inside-outside game of Towns, very solid. Not many big men can match him in that department.
Here's Baines. He's certainly been a consistent piece of their offense, averaging about 14 and a half points a game. Oubre gets the three-point of the call. Oubre's got an all-time account for the Suns.
And right there, Rubio doing what he does. Seeing the floor, exploring the defense, finding the open man, and getting the ball.
A nice shot by Culver.
Important points there. Got him on a nice play, getting the ball inside and right to the bucket.
And the Suns call time here. As the teams head into this timeout, a chance for the coaches now to map out some plays for the next few minutes and a chance for the players to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's important if they want to make sure they don't wear down later in the game.
Absolutely. Over the course of a game, you have to stay hydrated.
Sharich adds Johnson in for Kelly Oubre. Now, here's Rubio. He's playing a pretty big role for him at the offensive end, averaging about 12 and a half points a game. And he could not get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for two.
And, you know, even though in today's game, floor spacing is all the rage, in the last 5 years, the Wolves attempted the fewest threes in the league. And when they did shoot them, they didn't make very many of them.
And on top of their troubles from range, the Wolves have also had trouble on the defensive glass.
Yeah, and if you can't rebound and you're not shooting it well, you've got to figure out who you're going to be. Your identity is in question. That's what the Wolves are trying to figure out. Who are we? What do we do well? How do we win? How do we succeed? And get to the next level.
Squeeze
it well. Low turnovers can be a double-edged sword, though. If you don't make many mistakes, maybe you're not being aggressive enough.
Here's Vonleh. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Rubio against T. Shot clock at six. Here's Wiggins. And he hits it just before the shot clock expires. Wiggins has got his third basket of the night.
That makes it 10 of their last 12. Coming from inside the paint.
And finished off by Kaminsky.
You know, the thing about Kaminsky is he is a skilled shooter, but also a factor near the rim, too.
Teague, the pass to Culver. Pass to Wiggins. It down low. Wiggins has got nine.
Tell you what, he has been feeling it, guys, in the best game plan right now. It's elementary. Just keep feeding. Let him eat.
And they pick up two. Rubio's got the game tied up here for the Suns.
Right over the top. Rubio surveying the situation. This takes what the defense.
Teague against Rubio. Passes it to Vonleh. He dishes it to Wiggins. And there's the call on Devin Booker. That is his first foul of the game. Shep Diallo, he's checked in for Mikal Bridges. Timberwolves also changing it up. Towns, he's checked in for Gorgui Dang. And a Kogi subbed in for Kobe. Wiggins passes to Vonleh. Just fine on the clock. And post stops whistle on what looks to be an illegal screen.
Boy, in a game this snug, you can ill afford to commit those kinds of turnovers.
The Suns have gone 3-4 so far in the third quarter from the field. Pretty good start to the half. Kuzmi with the bounce pass. Johnson finds Booker. There's a minute 47 left to play in the third. Rubio, the pass to Kaminsky. Oh boy, hands up there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. That one is on Towns.
Yeah, when Frank Kaminsky plays like this with this kind of aggressiveness, it forces the defense to react.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one. Picking that number.
Well, it goes back to my idolization of Lew Alcindor at the time, who is now known as Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. He was the first big, graceful guy I saw do a little bit of everything in his days at UCLA. Digested all kinds of books and stories about him, and just really admired his work on and off the court. Because he wore 33, I chose 33.
Offensive rebound, Towns. It's stolen by Jackson. 1:22 left to play in the quarter. Shoots from the baseline. And finished up by Kaminsky.
Those arms of Kaminsky go on forever, which helped him snag these second chance opportunities.
Outside, Towns. A shot. That's it, and the Suns lead is cut down now to just 2 points with that basket from Nathan. And so it's Johnson who brings the ball up for the Phoenix Suns. Next up on the schedule, the Grizzlies. That'll be a home game. That'll be the second of 4 games at home for them. Here's Diallo. That's deflected. To the inside. And the basket by Nathan. Napier's got 4 this quarter.
Teague's ability to find the open man makes him one of the better passing point guards in the league.
The shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. Pass to Kaminsky. And Rubio kicks to Booker. Shoots. That's good. It's Rubio with the assist. Rubio's got his 4th assist with that last one here tonight. Here's Napier. And that one goes long. We're at the end of the third, and we've still got a close one. Suns lead by 2. 2 games force. Back to Phoenix after this. This fourth quarter promises to be a good one. The Timberwolves trail. Rubio and Booker, they're the backcourt. Oubre out there in charge. And Diallo in at the five. Down low. Which is out there for Phoenix. Towns, no luck. Now Phoenix shooting pretty good tonight at 58%. Teague against Charge. Booker outside. Back to Sharks. 6 on the shot clock. Over 2. Rebound Minnesota. Towns has got 6 rebounds here tonight.
overcome an off game from him offensively.
They get it again. Towns, a beautiful reverse layup. Towns has got it all tied up now for the Timberwolves.
Hey, I tell you what, I've got a 39-inch shirt sleeve. Oh, Anthony Towns has to be north of 40, and with that reach, you can see why he snatches up those rebounds.
Now here's Booker to the paint, and a rejection by Towns, and stolen by Booker. Suns lead by two. And look at how the hustle game has been going for the Suns.
The activity level defensively, I've really been impressed with. They've been in attack mode on the defensive end.
You know, adding on to that, if you look at their block totals tonight, and you see how feisty they've been on the defensive end this game.
You guys, the stellar development of Devin Booker continued last season. Still a firecracker on offense. Took strides to improve his shot selection, and equally as important, his decision making.
Kevin, I was able to listen in on what Ryan Saunders told his team. This is a close game, as you know, and he sounded extremely confident. He told the players, don't let up now, fellas. This is when we make our move, right now. Kevin?
Baines dishes to Dubray. You can't get that one. Timberwolves have gone 2-4 from the field since we started the...
Spectacular move. Wiggins' elevation, body control, strength. Across the board.
The pass to Baines. This is the Booker. And the whistle ball is going to be on Aaron Baines. That is his first foul of the game. And the Suns making a change here. Bridges checks in. With the ball. He'll bring it up for the Timberwolves. A great fourth quarter. Just giving up 2 points. Culver, the teardrop falls in. Culver's got the lead up to 4 now for the Timberwolves.
Boy, you look at the defense, not nearly the hustle or energy at that end of the floor. It's the exact opposite of what it was in the first half.
Now, here's Bridges. Rubio, right side. Here's Baines. Sharks trying to break free. Shots good by Baines.
And you don't want to allow too many of those short misses with the game right now in the balance.
Whistle blows. Bucket is good. He'll have a chance at the line to make it a 3-point play.
Points have been generated so far. Scoring breakdown for the Timberwolves. They keep piling up the assists, and they haven't cooled off at all.
They've also been pounding it inside tonight and coming away with a lot of points in the paint. I call those PIPs.
Suns trail by four. Nice ball movement by Phoenix. And here is Bridges. Towns has got double-digit rebounds now in the game. 16 feet away. Tries yet again. Oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard. And it's the Suns with the ball. They can use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
And the Suns call time here. You look at Towns, he's really been playing well.
He's really taking it to him inside. You got to find a way to slow him down.
Tonight, just amazing. He hadn't just been gunning. He's been picking his spots, and you need that kind of patience and discipline to shoot as well as he had.
That hasn't translated, though, to his shooting from the field.
We've got 1:28 left in the fourth quarter of this one. To the wing on the left. A 15-footer. Rebound, Minnesota. Towns has got rebound number 12 here already in the game. Here's Wiggins. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. It goes on Devin Booker.
That's going to be free throws. I mean, the length and quickness of Wiggins forcing the defender's hand there.
That's the first, and that makes it a 7-point lead.
You know, you think about Wiggins drafted number one overall a few years ago. So many expectations, and to be fair and honest, he's met most of them.
So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's an 8-point game. And so Booker will bring it up for Phoenix. Over Wiggins. Phoenix, no good that time either. Timberwolves on offense. They're on a 15-5 run. Over.
offensive glass, so very good at crashing the ball.